Once an infant has an abdominal wall closure, the next challenge is to initiate feeds. And that's a challenge.
It took them a week to do the closure surgery. It took another week at least, if not a little longer, for him to poop. And then they started feeding him 5 milliliters at a time.
The feeds are very small initially, oftentimes not more than a teaspoon. And we wait and watch.
And try to work them up to where they're taking enough calories and enough volume to be able to gain and grow, to get off their IV fluids.
We definitely had our patients tested with trying to get him to full feeds, especially I think it was even harder that he wanted to eat.
So it's a delicate balance. You want to advance the feeds as fast as you can to get them off, but yet you don't want to go too quickly and have a setback. Infants with abdominal wall defects are at risk of having a lot of trouble with reflux. And we try to do everything possible to treat them medically.
The need for therapy for gastroesophageal reflux is quite common with giant omphalocele. And those babies who don't respond to medical therapy, they may require an operation called a fundoplication, which creates a one-way valve to prevent gastroesophageal reflux.
To make it more difficult anatomically for reflux to occur, but we really try everything else before we get there. Babies with gastroschisis are at risk of something called late necrotizing enterocolitis.
That's a serious infection of the bowel that we'd like to minimize the risk thereof, and if it occurs, it usually responds to bowel rest and intravenous antibiotics.